Stelter. It's time for Reliable Sources. This is our weekly look at the story behind the story of how the media really works and how the news gets made. This weekend, breaking news from President Trump. He's upping his ferocious language against the news media and Robert Mueller. New York Times columnist David Leonhardt is here with a theory about what's going on. Plus, think of him as the storyteller in chief. Are we in the news media overanalyzing President Trump's statements, his stories? Should we really be analyzing him more like a novelist? A lot of thoughts to get to, a lot of angles to discuss, because the president is really attacking the press with renewed vigor. It's something we need to analyze in detail because it's something that's being talked about in newsrooms across the country right now. You might say his attacks against the media are becoming normalized in some way. Let me show you what I mean. I think it's as simple as this. President Trump's newest attempt to strip away our legitimacy and indeed our humanity is coming through on Twitter. He's posting these kinds of tweets. Here's one of them that I want us to take a look at and dissect. He is saying the fake news hates being called the enemy of the people only because they know it's true. He's claiming he's providing a great service to the public by explaining this. Here's what the president says about journalists. He says they purposely cause great division and distrust. They can also cause war, he says. They are very dangerous and sick. I know we're all used to him tweeting all the time, but just think about what he's saying here. The president, with his back up against the wall, is saying journalists are dangerous, sick, enemies of the people. That's where we are. This is America. Let me show you a few of the reactions from journalists this morning. Chuck Todd calling this outrageous. He's saying here, he tries not to take the bait, but this time he's reacting in the hopes that rational folks realize this is wrong and dangerous. Bill Kristol, an outspoken Trump critic, says the president sounds closer in spirit to Vladimir Putin than America. And SV Date, a White House reporter for the Post, pointed out that other leaders in the past have also used the phrase enemy of the people. Among those leaders, Joseph Stalin and Adolf Hitler. Look, enemy of the people does have a Stalin-era connotation. It was used in order to inflict pain and cause violence on populations of people throughout history. If the president doesn't know that, surely someone has told him by now. But you think about what's happened this week. There's been 3 days of rallies. The president singing the same tune, but singing it more loudly. He's shouting some of these attacks nowadays. And there's certainly been a newfound focus on how he whips up his crowds against the press corps. More and more, I think hate movement is the proper term for what's going on. But President Trump is not just telling his fans to ignore what we report. He's telling people that we are the enemy. Trump and some of his allies are promoting a hate movement against the American press. Now, I've been seeing that term used more and more. The first time I saw it more than a year ago, I think, was by NYU's Jay Rosen. Others are picking up on it as well. I think it's a helpful frame to understand what the president is doing. When we see people booing journalists at rallies, when we see the death threats that come in over social media, it's all part of this hate movement. And later in the hour, I want to show you one of the death threats that I recently received. We don't normally do this, but I'm going to play the phone call for you so you can get a sense of what it's like. But first, let's talk about the state of play, what the president's strategy is, if there is one, with two White House veterans. Here to talk about this is Anthony Scaramucci.